lands below. We are the dead. Short days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you, from failing hands, we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall sleep, though poppies grow. We shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders fields. But Lieutenant Colonel John McCrae, on December 8th, 1915.
Please be seated. Let us unite our hearts in prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God, you are our refuge and our strength, and we humble ourselves in your presence and remembering the great and mighty things you have done for us. We lift our hearts in adoration and praise. And as you have gathered our hearts and minds together this day, we give you thanks for all those who served their country in time of trial. In remembrance of those who laid down their lives for freedom and country, make us better men and women, and give us peace in our time. For this we pray in your name. Amen. Let us listen to the hymn, How Great Thou Art. Scripture I've chosen for today is taken from the Gospel of John, reading from chapter 1, verses 1 to 13. Let us hear the Word of God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God, and all things came into being through him. And without him, not one thing came into being. And what has come into being in him was life. And the life was the light of all people. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came into the world to testify to the light. The true light which enlightens everyone was coming into the world. And he was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become the children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. May the Lord bless to us this reading of his own word. I'm sure by now that you've noticed that our Remembrance Day service is quite a bit different from any other year. Due to the COVID, many changes needed to be made to the events of this year. And so, this is what it looks like for us this year. And there's very few people here. Most are watching it on some form of media from home or someplace. And we'd like to thank the town of Sylvan Lake for making that possible for us. There's no color party this year. There's no parade of people who serve our country, those who serve our community, our veterans. There's no honor guard, so you must stand in their place, honoring their memory and their sacrifice. You will witness a new way of laying wreaths, but each one that is laid will represent the thoughts and the reflections of many. The people that are here are by invitation, something that I never thought I would see for Remembrance Day service, but one that has been made due for us. But one thing remains constant. Why are we here? We're here to remember and pay tribute to the veterans of the two world wars whose armistice are remembered on November the 11th at the 11th hour. We also remember veterans of other wars and conflicts who served our country for the same reason: to fight against tyranny and oppression, to fight for freedom of all people. They went through the hell of war so that this world, you and I, could know a peace and freedom from such aspects of this hell. So we remember them. We set aside this hour, these few minutes on this day, to pay tribute to them. They did and still do many heroic things in carrying out their duty. But that they who served decades ago, or those who serve today, consider themselves heroes. Not many do. They consider themselves regular people with a dedication to serve their country and its people. We are the ones that call them heroes. They called themselves brothers and friends. Today they are called brothers and sisters, mothers and fathers, friends and comrades, all alike, all equal in our sight, and all deserving of honor and gratitude. And we who stand and remember them are aware, are unaware of what they really did, what they really saw. We've heard stories, and sometimes we hear personal stories. But I believe that even in those stories, we do not hear everything. We do not see what they saw. We cannot relive what they lived. We cannot feel the pain of shattered bodies and souls and minds. So we honor the unimaginable sacrifice that was made during these two great wars and every conflict since then. I've buried veterans from both World War I and World War II, and in one case, a person who served in both. I have officiated at many Legion memorial services and watched as comrades laid their poppies on the casket of friends. I have seen the tears and the faraway look, the lingering hand on the casket as they lay their poppy, and the emotion of a final farewell salute. I've stood in this place in a number of towns, and I've watched elderly men with walkers and canes march proudly and defiant of age to honor their friends and their brothers. I have watched as icicles form on the face of a young soldier as she stood in the wet, freezing rain at the corner of the cenotaph. She never moved, never displayed any discomfort. She only displayed the depth of her dedication and honor of those who have gone on before. I later learned that all four that were standing that day in the freezing rain had volunteered for that duty. I've prayed at the tomb of the unknown soldier, unknown except for his sacrifice, that unknown, unseen sacrifice that claimed his life. And I wondered over and over again about the how and the why and the what that these men and women faced. What caused them to go to war? Why did they go? What enemies did they face, both real and ideological? And what strength of character carried them forward? Did they know what they would see and ultimately have to do? And would it have made any difference if they had known? So many things we'll never know, or perhaps even comprehend. But we know this. They served their country in time of war and in the peacetime that they secured. They were our hope. Today, they are the reason for our hope. And they have handed the torch onto a new generation of men and women who now serve our country. We stand here looking dimly into the past to search for the only clear thing that we can see, the valor and dedication of those who fought and died for our freedom. We stand here with the hope that their sacrifice will never be forgotten. We stand here with the soldiers of our day praying that their willingness to serve our country will not demand the price it has in the past. We pray that the day will come when we will see their weapons turned to implements of hope and peace instead of implements of war. We pray that their sacrifice will bear witness to the light that will bring hope to a world often shrouded in darkness, and that the freedoms that they won for us and for this world will continue to grow and cause oppression and hatred to retreat into the face of all that these men and women fought to secure for us. And while we stand here, let us also remember those who serve this country at home and abroad. Let us remember the doctors and nurses who served by caring for the wounded and for the dying. Let us be thankful for their dedication, as well as the fact that we have not had to witness what they had to endure. But let's honor their work and their caring. And let us also remember during this time of pandemic and darkness, those veterans who are seeking assistance for disability benefits, those who are left waiting for much needed support. There are still about 19,000 men and women waiting for their applications to be dealt with. Speak out on their behalf, They served us. Let us help them get the assistance that they need. And let us remember also the many branches of the Royal Canadian Legion that support and care for veterans and members. Let us keep them in our prayers and support them as they struggle to survive during COVID. And finally, let us do the little thing of keeping each other safe in the face of this pandemic that has caused us to alter our daily lives and our routines in minor ways. Let us truly honor the selfless acts of others who laid down their lives for us by caring for one another today during this pandemic. We may feel invincible in the face of this deadly foe, but we are the ones who need to protect the most vulnerable of our friends and our family. Let us do what we can do to keep everyone safe in remembrance of those who have kept us safe and who today we honor. Amen. I'm going to ask that we hear Amazing Grace. Please stand with me now for the last post and remain standing for the 2 moments of silence. Thank you. Let us unite our hearts in prayer. Let us pray. O God, our Father, we thank you for the valiant hearts of all who at the call of sovereign and country laid down their lives in the cause of freedom. We pray that we may uphold the torch entrusted to us, that their sacrifice may not have been in vain, and unite all peace-loving people of our world in one holy purpose, to defend the principles of freedom and unity of all people for which these valiant hearts lived and died. Let there be peace on this earth, and let it continue to be sought by us. In the name of our Prince of Peace, we pray. Amen. They shall not grow old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. You may be seated. Let's listen to the hymn, Eternal Father, Strong to Save.
To lay the wreaths, and I ask each of you, I'll call out your names and you can gather your wreath and you can come up to the cenotaph and lay it, please. I would also ask that you would just lay your wreath rather than have them all sort of clumped in front of the cenotaph. If you just spread them out on either side of the cenotaph a little bit, if you wouldn't mind, please. Laying a wreath on behalf of Her Majesty the Queen, we have Staff Sergeant Jeff McGrath. Laying a wreath on behalf of Canada and on behalf of our Member of Parliament, Blank Hawkins, with Jolene Pufford. Brief on behalf of the province, we have our member of the Legislative Assembly, Devin Christian. laying a wreath on behalf of the town of Sylvan Lake, we've got Mayor Sean McIntyre. Laying a wreath on behalf of the Silvercroft mothers, we have Shirley Wilson. Laying a wreath on behalf of the Canadian Armed Forces, we have Warrant Officer Jim Wilson. Laying a wreath on behalf of the Royal Canadian Legion, we have our President, Ed Stevenson. Laying a wreath on behalf of the Ladies Legion Auxiliary, Gwendolyn McCletchen. Laying a wreath on behalf of the veterans' families, we have Larry Nice. And laying a wreath on behalf of the service clubs and the Church of Sylvan Lake, we have Jim Dick. Thank you.
Please stand with me now for God Save the Queen. God, you brought us to this place to remember these, your people, to honor the sacrifice that they have made, to live within the freedom that they fought to bring to us. Lord, help us to honor them. Help us to honor them with our living. And go with us as we leave this place of remembrance. Go with us to serve you, our God, to serve our country, and to serve our community. Go in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated.
Through this door over here, keeping a safe distance.